Desmond Doss, born February 7, 1999, in Virginia, known as a church member, a neighbor, a husband, a father, and a hero. Being shown is his childhood home where his character was molded. Doss saw great tragedy and triumphed in his own way during his life. The morals that led him to experience the fall and rise within his life started in early childhood. Growing up with his father, mother, a brother, and his sister in his household, a large part of their life focused on their religion, with his mother, Bertha, heavily involved in teaching her children the way of God. That religion shaped Doss into the man he needed during his time in the war, keeping his head on his shoulders and a Bible in his hands. As religion did play a big part in his morals, so did his father's actions that ultimately scarred him as a young child. His father, William, and his uncle spent a night heavily drinking that led them to become intoxicated and ultimately brewed up a fight. Doss's father pulled out a gun and pointed it at his uncle. Doss's brave mother intervened and demanded the gun. When she received it, she put it in Doss's hands and instructed him to go hide it. Doss vowed to never pick up a gun that day forward because of the violence he witnessed. With the family being so religious, the Ten Commandments, the very one in his household shown here, hung proudly in the Doss household, which happened to be the one Doss looked at and pondered his father's actions with the gun. "Thou shalt not kill" became engraved into his memory and stuck proudly with him throughout his time in war. He grew up to speak in youth, in the church groups, and worked carpentry, but he eventually volunteered for the war. So why would a man that wanted nothing to do with weapons join the military? It comes down to a sense of wanting to help people, no matter the person. Those who were turned away because of mental issues or incomplete training committed suicide. These unspeakable acts drove him wanting to save lives. He entered active duty on April 1, 1942, and enlisted as a combat medic. From then on, he was ridiculed throughout training and beaten constantly because of his actions concerning his religious beliefs. He earned the name Conscientious Objector for his refusal to handle or even touch a gun due to his commitments to his religion. This led to his commanding officer rebunking Doss's unit's weekend passes, which led to even more beatings. Still, Doss stuck to his beliefs. In order to take his Sabbath every Saturday, he worked all day on Sunday. Despite all the beating and ridicule, he remained stubborn and did what he believed was right. As boot camp was coming to a close and his time in war approaching, he was put on trial. Since he didn't complete his training in boot camp, there was no possibility of him continuing on into the war. Fortunately, President Truman signed off on an official document allowing Doss to continue on whether he carried a gun or not. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear. In the spring of 1945, at Okinawa, Doss's company needed to climb a steep, jagged cliff, Hacksaw Ridge, to a plateau where thousands of heavily armed Japanese soldiers waited. As the battle raged on, the Japanese were quickly advancing upon the American unit. Many soldiers fell. Doss crawled under a barrage of gunfire and explosions, nicknamed the Rain of Steel by the Japanese, to the wounded soldiers and dragged them to the edge of the cliff. He tied a rope around the severely injured soldiers and lowered them down to the medics below. The knot he used was remarkably created himself, served as a safer option, now officially named the double bowline knot. Its efficiency and effectiveness secured the men he lowered down. He saved around 75 men, including his captain Jack Glover, over a 12-hour period while repeating to himself, "Lord, help me get one more."
A Unfortunately, he suffered extensive injuries to his left arm, which ended any possibilities of him continuing his career in carpentry. In 1946, he was diagnosed with tuberculosis, which caused him to undergo treatment for 5.5 years. He lost a lung and 5 ribs before being discharged from the hospital in August in 1951 with 90% disability. After an overdose of antibiotics, he was rendered deaf and 100% disabled. He was able to regain his hearing after receiving a cochlear implant in 1988. After the death of his first wife, Dorothy, on November 17, 1991, Desmond was remarried to Frances in 1993. Desmond had a son, Desmond Thomas Doss Jr., with Dorothy, but did not have any with Frances. His son did not follow in his father's footsteps with religion, but did respect his religion. In interviews, Mr. Doss Jr. mentioned he respected the movie made about his father as well. Desmond unfortunately passed away March 23, 2006 at the age of 87 before he could read the first script of his movie. During his lifetime, Doss was approached many times by writers, producers, and directors for his legacy he left behind in the war. A majority of the time, he turned them away because of his religion, until finally he agreed along with exceptions that had to be made. He made it absolutely clear that the movie had to have solid facts and remain true to not only himself, but his time in the war. The producer who agreed selected a few Seventh-day activists to read the script in Doss's place and provide resource materials upon request. A strong bond was formed between the council, producers, cast and film distributors. The council became very involved in the production and promotions of the movie. Desmond Doss was portrayed by the talented Andrew Garfield, whose Doss's son approved of highly. 33-year-old Garfield accurately portrayed Doss's speech, mannerisms, and humble personality, despite being 10 years younger than Doss during his time in the war. The memoriam statue of Doss is in Collegedale, Tennessee's Veterans Memorial Park. An exhibit in Charles Coolidge Medal of Honor Museum, Chattanooga, Tennessee honored Doss along with the Hall of Heroes, Pentagon, Washington, D.C. Doss Memorial, Seventh-day Adventist Church, Naha, Okinawa. A memorial is also stationed at the U.S. Army Medical Department Museum from San Antonio, Texas. After all of his hardships, he was recognized by receiving the Medal of Honor in May 1945, 2 Bronze Stars, and the Purple Heart. He was also promoted to corporal after his act at Okinawa. Desmond Doss, an unusual hero, one that used the power of prayer to save his comrades. His memory will live on. He will serve as an example to stand up for what you believe in.
As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sisters, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sisters, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to